Welcome back. It's been about a month since I've done a pageant related video, so let's get into it. Today I want to do something fun, exciting, easygoing, and that is talking about the first runner-up gowns at Miss Universe from 2005 to 2019. I did do a video on the winning gowns of Miss Universe and talked about my favorites. I did the farewell gowns of Miss Universe about 2005 to 2019 or 2004 to 2019. And then now I'm gonna do the first runner-up gowns. This was requested by quite a few people. It was something I thought about as well, but I was happy to see that people wanted to hear me talk about it. In 2005, the first runner-up was Miss Puerto Rico. Miss Puerto Rico wore this stunning black number, very sparkly. It had this like sheer high leg situation happening. She looked absolutely beautiful. Of course, that year Natalie Glebova won Miss Universe for Canada. She was wearing a white dress, so it was kind of cool to see white and black as the final two. This gown was amazing. Now we have 2006 first runner up also wearing black, which is very interesting to me. This one, it's a little bit more, I don't want to say casual, but certainly it has a look that isn't as pageanty, if you will. It looks a little bit more high fashion. In 2006, I really felt like the entire top five had very casual summer kind of maxi dress vibes besides the winner, Puerto Rico. So I just felt like this top five was very non-traditional with the gowns. Then we moved to 2007. The first runner-up is Brazil. Brazil had a very more pageant type dress, but what was interesting to me is that in 2006, the first runner-up was Japan, and then in 2007, the winner was Japan. Now, if you notice, in 2005, the first runner-up was Puerto Rico. In 2006, the winner was Puerto Rico. You following me? But anyways, this video isn't about that. This video is about the first runner-up gown. So the 2007 Miss Brazil, she had this bedazzled silver gorgeous gown, and then you're probably gonna hear Lily chattering because she's right here playing with her stickers. It's just her and I right now. So in 2008 we had the first runner-up Miss Colombia and the winner Miss Venezuela. This year I felt like both of them were the most playful, fun, exciting to watch women in evening gown for a long time. I thought they both nailed evening gown, and I, looking back, I'm like, how would the judges have decided between the two of them if it was only based on evening gown? I don't really know. Now that's in terms of their performance. In terms of the actual gown of Miss Colombia, to be totally honest, I'm not a big fan of this gown. However, she rocked it. She performed so well in this gown. I loved the way it moved. 2009 Dominican Republic. There's a lot of people who actually felt like Dominican Republic should have won that year. In terms of her gown, I thought it was a little bit too wedding-ish, too bridal in my opinion. It was absolutely gorgeous. Of course, all of these gowns are amazing. It's really hard to pick them apart. I just like to be a little bit more picky and critical and try to find something that I could say critique about them. Nonetheless, Miss Dominican Republic looked amazing. 2010 Jamaica. So many people love this woman, and it's hard to deny why. She had an amazing, beautiful, wonderful performance. This gown to me though, I want to love it, but there's just something that's off about it for me. I don't know if it's the material. Something makes it look cheap, in my opinion. It could be thousands and thousands of dollars, but there's just something about the color and the material that just isn't working for me. In terms of the still shots, once again, in motion, in video, I felt like it had a lot more of a wow factor. 2011 Ukraine. This woman looked like an angel. Still to this day, she reminds me of a Victoria's Secret angel. I know a lot of you loved her as well, and we have seen this gown done by many since her. She looked impeccable. 2012 Philippines. I've talked about this woman many times. I've talked about her gown. I personally loved the gown. I loved the color. It was very Cinderella-esque for me. The gown is very Cinderella-esque for me, but I know there's a lot of you who think it looks cheap or something, or you're just not a fan of it. So let me know in the comments of what you thought of Janine Taganon, Miss Universe Philippines 2012's gown. 2013 Miss Spain. I love this woman. woman. She was one of my favorite contestants when I was following Miss Universe 2013. I thought her gown was absolutely exquisite. The detailing around the bust, I thought it was amazing, and I just felt like she rocked it so beautifully. I think this is one of my favorite first runner-up gowns for sure. 2014, Nia Sanchez, Miss USA. To be completely honest, I loved Nia's gown that she wore at Miss USA more than the gown that she wore to represent USA at Miss Universe. But you know what? She looked absolutely wonderful, flawless, amazing. The red looked beautiful on her. 2015, Colombia. All I can say is wow, wow, wow. It is so hard to deny the beauty of this gown, the way she rocked it, her confidence. I always joke that her boobs remind me of like two disco balls or something in the best way possible. It hugs every inch of her body to perfection. 2016, Haiti. I of course was there. I was competing that year. I was on stage. I saw Miss Haiti's gown and it looked wonderful on her. It actually gave me like this golden mermaid vibe. I believe it's a Colombian designer and I thought she looked exquisite. I loved like the higher neck on her, the way she had the low ponytail. She looked very regal. 2017, again, Colombia. I was there in person. For all of you who have been here for a while, you know that we got married the day of Miss Universe 2017. We got married and then we went to watch Miss Universe with our moms. So I saw Colombia's gown in real life and I thought it was incredible.
One of you is about to become our new Miss Universe. If for any reason the winner is unable to fulfill her duties, the first runner-up will take her place. Good luck to you both. The new Miss Universe is South Africa!
Then we have 2018 South Africa. Again, another silver, exquisite dress. This again could be like a disco ball in the best way possible. So sparkly, amazing. I love the lines. I love the way it fit her body. And then the skirt just kind of, not really flowed. It just like hung beautifully. But part of the issue, if you guys remember this, when Miss South Africa was walking in the evening gown competition, she got tripped up a little bit. So I think the skirt was like catching on her heels or something, or she was kind of tripping on it. Nonetheless, she looked impeccable. What a remarkable woman. She could easily win Miss Universe if she would have competed a different year. Love her, love the gown. Incredible. Now we are at 2019. The first runner up was Miss Puerto Rico. If you guys heard my reviews, if you saw my reviews, we were there in person.
Runner up for Miss Universe 2019 is Miss Universe is South Africa.
My brother Layton and Lily and I were at Miss Universe 2019 in Atlanta, Georgia.
South Africa is going to win.
And to be totally honest, I was a little bit disappointed in Madison's gown. When she came out in it, I thought she still looked amazing. She's obviously an incredible woman, a wonderful contestant for Miss Universe. But this gown to me, I just felt like it didn't do her justice. Like I felt like a different style of gown or a different color, something could have been more wow factor for her just because she is that amazing. She has a wonderful walk, beautiful stage presence. I wasn't a big fan of this gown. Some people absolutely love it. Again, difference in opinion. So my personal three favorite first runner-up gowns, 2013, Miss Spain, 2015, Colombia, and honestly, I'm gonna have to say 2017, Colombia again. Not only does Colombia have amazing contestants for Miss Universe, they have incredible designers that are able to capture these women in the best light, in their best moments, in the, I guess, highlight really of their pageant lives being on the Miss Universe stage. So let me know in the comments what your favorite first runner-up gown was at Miss Universe. Why was it your favorite? What made it stand out to you? And as always, if you guys want to hear more from me, you can always hit that subscribe button and join the over 100,000 of us that are in this community. And I look forward to seeing you guys in my next video. Oh, and one thing I forgot to mention, let me know as well in the comments what you want to see next for me. There's a lot more happening in the pageant world right now, and I'm struggling to figure out which I should highlight, what I should talk about, and I always like to make my videos based on your guys' requests, so let me know.